in other words, of Pope Francis.
Lismental kafalikike dochlek. La ley del Señor es perfecta.
The Holy Father begins with a few words in the local language. The law of the Lord is perfect, it revives the soul.
La ley del Señor es perfecta.
Thus begins the psalm we have just heard, the Pope says. The law of the Lord is perfect, and the psalmist diligently lists everything that the law offers to those who hear and follow it. It revives the soul, it gives wisdom to the simple, it gladdens the heart, it gives light to the eyes.
Esa es la ley que el pueblo de Israel había recibido de mano de Moisés, una ley que ayudaría al pueblo de Dios.
This is the law which the people of Israel received from the hand of Moses, a law that would help the people of God to live in the freedom to which they were called.
Para sus pasos y acompañar el peregrinar de su pueblo.
A law intended to be a light for the journey and to accompany the pilgrimage of his people. A people who experienced slavery and the Pharaoh's tyranny, who endured suffering and oppression to the point where God said, enough, no more.
No más. He visto la aflicción, he oído el clamor, he conocido su angustia. Y ahí se manifiesta el rostro.
Enough, no more. I have seen their affliction, I have heard their cry,
el rostro del
I know their sufferings.
Sufre ante el dolor. El
and here the true face of God is seen, the face of the Father who suffers as he sees the pain, mistreatment, and lack of justice for his children. His word, his law, thus becomes a symbol of freedom, a symbol of joy, of wisdom, and of light. It is an experience, a reality, which is conveyed by a phrase prayed in Popol Vuh and born of the wisdom accumulated in these lands since time immemorial.
La paz de la tierra fue enseguida sanada.
The dawn rises on all of the tribes together. The face of the earth was immediately healed by the sun.
Y otra vez han caminado en las distintas tinieblas de la historia.
The sun rose for the people who at various times have walked in the midst of history's darkest moments.
Hay un anhelo de vivir en libertad.
In this expression, one hears the yearning to live in freedom. There is a longing which contemplates a promised land where oppression, mistreatment, and humiliation are not the currency of the day.
En el corazón del hombre y en la memoria de muchos de nuestros pueblos está inscrito.
In the heart of man and in the memory of many of our peoples is imprinted this yearning for a land, for a time when human corruption will be overcome by fraternity.
La injusticia sea vencida por la solidaridad.
When injustice will be conquered by solidarity and when violence will be silenced by peace.
Nuestro Padre no solo comparte este anhelo, él mismo lo ha estimulado y lo estimula.
Our Father not only shares this longing, but has himself inspired it and continues to do so in giving us his Son, Jesus Christ. In him we discover the solidarity of the Father who walks by our side. In him we see how the perfect law takes flesh, takes a human face, shares our history so as to walk with and sustain his people. He becomes the way, he becomes the truth, he becomes the life, so that darkness may not have the last word, and the dawn may not cease to rise on the lives of his sons and daughters.
De muchas maneras y de muchas formas se ha querido silenciar.
In many ways, there have been attempts to silence and dull this yearning, and in many ways, there have been efforts to anesthetize our soul.
De muchas formas han pretendido,
and in many ways, there have been endeavors to subdue and lull our children and young people into a kind of lassitude by suggesting that nothing can change, that their dreams can never come true.
Frente a estas formas, la creación también sabe levantar su voz.
Faced with these attempts, creation itself also raises an objection. The sister now cries out to us because of the harm we have inflicted on her by our irresponsible use and abuse of the goods with which God has endowed her. We have come to see ourselves as her lords and masters, entitled to plunder her at will. The violence present in our hearts, wounded by sin, is also reflected in the symptoms of sickness evident in the soil, in the water, in the air, and in all forms of life.
Por eso, entre los pobres más abandonados y maltratados, está nuestra.
This is why the earth herself, burdened and laid waste, is among the most abandoned and maltreated of our poor. She groans in travail, citing Romans 8:2 in a quote from Laudato Si, the Pope's own encyclical. The environmental challenge that we are experiencing and its human causes affects us all. Again, referring to Laudato Si, and demands our response. We can no longer remain silent before one of the greatest environmental crises in world history. In this regard, you have much to teach us.
Como han reconocido los obispos de América Latina, saben relacionarse armónicamente con la naturaleza.
In this, your peoples, as the bishops of Latin America have recognized, know how to interact harmoniously with nature, which they respect as a source of food, a common home, and an altar of human sharing, the Pope pointing to the Aparecida statement. And yet, on many occasions, in a systematic and organized way, your people have been misunderstood and excluded from society. Some have considered your values, culture and traditions to be inferior. Others, intoxicated by power, money, and market trends, have stolen your lands or contaminated them. How sad this is. How worthwhile it would be for each of us to examine our conscience and learn to say, "Forgive me."
Perdón, hermanos. El mundo.
Forgive me, my brothers.
Despojado por la cultura.
Today's world, ravaged as it is by a throwaway culture, needs you.
Necesita ustedes. Los jóvenes de hoy, expuestos a una cultura que intenta suprimir todas las riquezas.
Exposed to a culture that seeks to suppress all cultural heritage and features in pursuit of a homogenized world, the youth of today need to cling to the wisdom of their elders.
El mundo de hoy, preso del pragmatismo.
Today's world, overcome by convenience, needs to learn anew the value of gratitude.
Estamos celebrando la certeza de que el creador no nos abandona.
We rejoice in the certainty that the Creator does not abandon us. He never forsakes his loving plan or repents of having created us. Again, citing Laudato Si. We rejoice that Jesus continues to die and rise again in each gesture that we offer to the least of our brothers and sisters.
Siendo testigos de su pasión.
Let us be resolved to be witnesses to his passion and his resurrection by giving flesh to these words.
La ley del Señor.
Once again, citing a few words in the local language, the verse from the psalm, the law of the Lord is perfect and comforts the soul. And again, the verse he quoted at the beginning of his homily, and now we will have a few moments of silence to reflect on the gospel, on the readings.